kind of magic. It's a kind of magic. A kind of magic.
On what turned out to be a blustery, but against expectations dry day, the gates of the recreation club opened to the sound of music, coming from a family fun day which was organised by the works employees for their families, friends and local residents. The fun day was formally opened by our works manager David Hyde. Hey, don't hog the shop, Malky. It was ably supported on the platform by Lady Di, who looks vaguely familiar. The Grangemouth Gala Queen, Elaine Tweedy, released the balloons and was presented with a bouquet of flowers by Mrs. Hyde. From reliable local sources, I understand that the Bowness Fair Queen was previously engaged doing something entertaining at Balmoral, would you believe? A smart-looking fella that in the tipfer. Thankfully, the weather was kind to us and the occasion was well attended. The canteen ladies did their bit, dressing up as Diddy men and handing out lollipops. I suppose, really, we should call them Diddy ladies. Now, here's a pretty sight. Looks like it's Lorraine's turn to buy a round. What have we here? Is it Roland or Splat the Rat? Doubtless Shuggy will have something more refined. Bells, by the look of it. I think we'd better continue before we find ourselves filming the arrival of the RSPCA. Shades of Sheila Forrest? No. Someone's trying to beat Kenny Miles at darts. Some hope. Bristol couldn't do that. Kenny? You require 88. I wonder what's inside that thing, flying the flags. Let's have a look inside. Well, that's one way of having fun. That's enough of the commercials. Let's get out of here. An army tent? What's this all about? I see a cafe. There appears to be some kind of problem. Why a gendarme? Ah, it all becomes clear. It's Herr Flick, Olivier, Marlene Dietrich and company in the cast of Allo Allo. Could they possibly be saluting David March? Come on, Ronnie. Give the kids a chance. Make those holes bigger for next year. Fine safekeeper. That may have saved some money. Keep it up. Whose twinkle toes are these? Surely Eddie's not trying to teach his wife to putt. Remember getting the wooden spoon from the foreman, Eddie? Now to the friendly display, or is it rivalry, of gymnastics? Surely one of these young ladies didn't say anything to upset her. Perhaps they should change over to this sport. Sometimes things are not quite what they seem. For example, you may think this is a display by the 3rd Battalion of the 51st Highland Volunteers, when in reality, it's a group of shop stewards practicing new revolutionary techniques to use on Alistair Grant and perhaps George Roberts. It's being proved a spectacular success. In the quieter part of the grounds, pony rides were available for the children. My lovers preferred their own transport. Noticed David Hyde hanging around these? No. No, I categorically refuse to say that these are Pat Lundy's lot. Tempting though. Although this is primarily a fun day, any profits that are made are being donated to local children's charities. So get your money out of your pockets. From guns to target bowls, with these bowlers showing just how accurate they can be. This raft is operational and is raced at various events throughout the year by safety services to help raise money, again for charity and worthy causes. And now to the children's races. This little fella seems keen enough to run, and no wonder, with this crowd chasing him. Typical. Malky, Danny and the Bruce brothers expecting a miracle from five-year-olds. Teams entered for this competition, which was a very good response. They certainly seem to represent all age groups, and presumably they are all at a high level of fitness. There's Pete Stevenson, captain of B team. He'll definitely be intending to drive his team to victory. Gorilla's aping it up a bit, and by the time the day's finished, I'm sure he'll smell like one. I hope the first aid station has a good supply of oxygen. And here's Superman in the lead. I suppose we can't be surprised about that. I heard he could carry a good bucket. A balloon bursting competition. The things that one could say, perhaps no comment is safest here. The race continues with the contestants getting younger and the pails getting smaller. The official markers. Why are you hiding your drink there, Marie? Perhaps she's flapping because she has Tommy Riss sitting beside her. The fun day seemed a suitable time to have a car draw. And here's the works manager, closely supervised by John Thompson, chairman of the fun day committee. Makes J.A. Faulkner very happy by calling out his number. Imagine anyone involved in a raffle being a rigger. Surely this typifies what the fun day is all about. Here's Monty and Andy, two worthy protagonists, apparently. No, not apparently, definitely, having no difficulty in smiling together for the camera. We're now at the end of this short video. I hope you've enjoyed it and helps to encourage you to greater efforts next year, because no doubt this is going to become calendar event. Love will see you.